to assisted living, to hospice. Our motto, like a lot of the industry, is, you know, age in place. So we'd like to, as long as we can provide the care services needed for the resident, then they can stay in, as long as it's within our scope of practice. Let's see what else. Hiring right now, we're kind of at a taking resumes and applications and just having a nice funnel, because I don't know when my staff is going to have something happen in their life. But most often, all of our employees, I think the average has been 4 years or longer. So I think the longest was 9 years. Looking for CNAs, ideally with 2 or more years experience. But if you're a go-getter, we'll review. So in the interview process, it just kind of like, the goal is, as an employer, and this is basic before we create a relationship, my goal is to get the most amount of work out of the employee for the least amount of pay. Employee's goal is to get the, you know, most amount of pay for the least amount of work, right? So now we just need to meet somewhere in the middle, and now we've got a business relationship. And then I think tips for, like, dress for success. I mean, if you come in scrubs, I'm fine with that, because that's how you're going to dress. If you're an attorney, you're probably going to wear a suit. So, you know. And then we're flexible. I have another company where we do promotional products and company uniforms. So it's great. I can staff you with the uniform too if we want, or everything's flexible. As long as you're accountable, I'm flexible.
So I work at the Everett Clinic. I work in People Services. I'm one of our clinical recruiters, overseeing primarily our medical assisting positions, as well as anything in the lab, radiology, and vision center environments. But then we have my kind of counterpart in recruitment oversees a lot of our nursing positions and things like that. So a lot of different opportunities with us. Most of you are probably familiar with the Everett Clinic already. We have over 15 locations throughout Snohomish County and then into northern King County now, as well with our Shoreline location that we opened in September, and a Woodinville location that's opening next month. So we're growing right now. We have a lot of opportunities, because every time we open a new site, that means we have more people that we need on our team. So that's kind of a little bit about the Everett Clinic. We're a primary care, urgent care, specialty care clinic. We have over 40 different specialties. So if there's any type of specialty department that you have interest in, we probably have it, and we are probably staffing for it. Lots of opportunities to continue to grow within the world of healthcare, especially when you're kind of one of the benefits of being in a larger organization is you do have those opportunities to grow without necessarily having to go get a job in a different organization. So kind of the two different elements where you can, for some people, being in a small organization with a real family feel is what you're looking for, and sometimes the larger organization. So it kind of just depends on the person. Neither one is right or wrong. We pride ourselves at the Everett Clinic on being a large organization that still has that family feel. Because a lot of our satellites are in smaller communities, then that kind of helps. For each team, you're kind of like your own organization within the large organization. So you still have your smaller team of the people you're working with on a regular basis and things like that. And we really want it to be a two-way interview process. We are really passionate about person-job fit. You want the right person in the right job. We don't just want someone who can do the job, but someone who's going to really like it and want to be there and be motivated to come to work and be satisfied there, because that type of person and that type of fit is going to provide better care for our patients. So that's something that we're really looking for. Kind of along that, kind of across the board, the things that I'm always looking for in every candidate are someone who kind of has the balance between the people skills and the detail-oriented side of things. Because you can go too far on either extreme and it doesn't work, but if you have balance of both of those things, then that's kind of that sweet spot. Teamwork probably then for me is the final thing that's really important as far as what I'm looking for, because in healthcare, nobody is an island. Everybody has kind of their own separate scope based on your position, and then even people within the same position have their own kind of niche of what they're working on based on what provider they're working with or what patient population they're working with, and all of that has to come together in order to have coordinated care, because there's that complexity of healthcare that makes teamwork important. And so everybody has to really work together, from our reception team to our clinical staff to our providers to administrative departments. Everybody has to be able to coordinate that care and work together in order to provide the best care.
We look after about 165 senior citizens. We have about 152 apartments, so we're about a medium-sized retirement community. We're not big, we're not small, we're somewhere in the middle. About 70% of my residents are fully independent, and about 30% receive some level of assisted living services, and that's where the nurse, the LPN, and the caregivers come in. Our company has some very, we have a kind of a different, in my opinion, forward-thinking corporate culture. Some of our slogans, some of the things that we're pushed to do will kind of explain that. For example, our company slogan is five-star fun. I was in hotel management for 21 years, never heard anything close to that. What our president says is, my responsibility as a general manager is to make sure that my residents have the opportunity to have fun every single day. We look for people who have the desire and willingness to care for others, and we treat them fairly. You can earn more money working somewhere else, of that I am certain. But I don't know that you'll find a better overall working experience than you might find with us. Come into the front desk, we're open 24 hours a day, get an application, fill it out. Whatever is the appropriate department head will call you in for an interview. If you do well with them, they'll ask you to come in for a second interview with me. And I will tell you, in 12 years, anybody that's gone through a first interview with my department heads and passed them, I've never said no. So your second interview is a piece of cake.
So our company goal is to, we have individuals that are able to remain in their homes or their communities with our help. And so we provide skilled nursing care, RNs and LPNs and occupational therapists and physical therapists and certified nursing assistants. And our office is located in Edmonds, but we help clients all over the Seattle area. I'd like to say within a 2-hour radius in every direction of Edmonds. What sets our company apart is it's one-on-one care. It's great for some people, not great for others. Some CNAs love it because you get a bond with your client. You get to really focus on your client and help improve their life. So the interview process, I'll talk a little about that. When we invite you to come in for an interview, I definitely pay attention if you showed up on time. If you show up late, I'm such a nice person, but if you show up late, you see like a different side of me because I actually send you home. And the reason being is because if you're going to show up late to interview with me, you're going to show up late to my client's house. And I tell them that. And they're like, no, I promise. I'm like, you showed up late here. I know you're going to show up late. So I send you home. Also, the phone, that's the one that does drive me crazy. If you have your phone on, it rings. If you answer your phone during the interview, that really makes me not so happy. So you probably won't pass the interview process. I'll talk about some benefits. So we offer a 401k, and our pay range, it's a real wide spectrum. Anywhere from $13.75 an hour to $18 an hour, and it just depends. We work in some facilities, so if a facility has a CNA that calls in sick, or doesn't show up to work, or we can fill those shifts for them within like 10 minutes time a lot of times. Hopefully an hour's notice. So if you work in a facility through us, we're gonna be able to pay you about $18 an hour. But normal one-on-one care is around $14 to $15 an hour. And like I mentioned before, we're big into tuition, so we do have tuition reimbursement. And there's a lot of room to grow in the company. I have several positions where I offered someone a job today that was a superstar CNA for the last 6 months, and I promoted her to come work for me, under me in operations. And so I have three people like that are CNAs, and that they do emergency shifts for me, and then they help me in the office. So it's a pretty good promotion for them.
Basically what we're looking for in our Snohomish County clinics, which would be Everett and Linwood. So right off the bat, we are totally looking for ARNPs, LPNs, RNs, MAs, especially MAs, pharmacy assistants. We also have patient access rep openings, which are basically like our entry-level front desk positions. That's kind of how I actually got in the door, was actually at Everett as a patient access rep, and kind of worked my way up from there. So it's an excellent way to get in. So Kaiser Washington is an HMO. So what that means, it's like an integrated care company. So we give care, pretty much anything you need, but also we are health insurance as well. So it kind of saves you money when everything is kind of in-house. And so we kind of use that to keep costs down. And also Kaiser, just like Group Health, is a not-for-profit company. And in our region, we have 26 primary care clinics, and we stretch as far north as Bellingham, and as far south as Olympia, and we also are on the Kitsap Peninsula, and looking to expand. And we are also in the Spokane region as well. Kaiser Permanente Washington is very focused on internal promotions. Our executive in human resources really was pushing for that. I was actually her executive assistant for about a year and a half, and she was so adamant that we had to stop like focusing on hiring outside people for management positions and start kind of bringing people up from the bottom and making sure that people are coming in entry level and they can work their way up the ladder easily and try to guide people into management and in hopefully even executive positions eventually.
So we're extremely mission-based. Our mission is to provide a diverse community with access to high-quality, affordable primary health care, and that it's very important to us that a healthy community is achieved through access to that health care. What many people don't know about us is we also provide behavioral health and psychiatric care as well. It's a great need in our county, and that we provide that. We actually have an RNP who goes out to our homeless population every single day and works with them, especially at night, to find them the basic medical care that they need. We work with our school districts to get our students sealants. We have a sealant program as well. We do provide benefits, so our medical, dental, and vision is provided free to our employees. If you'd like to add your dependents, you can certainly do that. If there is a cost to you, you pay the difference between the employee portion and what the company needs to pay for that. We also have, of course, paid time off, extended illness banks, short-term disability. We have a 403B, which is similar to a 401K, but it's 403B because it's a nonprofit. And after your first year of service, the company will actually match dollar for dollar up to the first 5% that you contribute to your 403B. And tuition assistance, that's important. We actually have quite a few medical assistants who will come into our organization, and they realize actually they want to become an RN and go that step further. So we will actually help support them, not only keep them employed and pay for part of their schooling, but help them actually career path and get into the next role that they would like to get into. We do offer externships too. They're unpaid, but we do partner with different schools in the Snohomish County to have externships at our locations. Of course, it's all about the mission. So as long as you're mission-based, would be a great fit for CHC. Like I said, if you're looking for just a JOB, it's not going to be the best place for you to be.
One of the current initiatives of Providence is to kind of cater to the nursing shortage that everyone is going to have. So they have a nursing academy, which is kind of devoted to the curriculum for our residents and fellows. They cater a lot to CNAs who are in school to become an RN. So they're very flexible, with your schedule. So another great thing to keep in mind. I would say for the hiring process is pretty general, regardless if you apply through Indeed or any of those other sources. It's all fed into our applicant tracking system. I have to agree. Please make sure that your resume is up to date. Include all of your experience. Make sure there's no typos. Our system doesn't require you to attach a resume, but I would highly recommend that you do that. It does require you to put in one job as part of your history, and if you just have like your recent job that you started a month ago, that looks like you're a brand new, whatever your position is. So I highly recommend that you attach that as well. For interviewing, same thing, come dressed professionally. We have had people show up in see-through shirts, and it doesn't end very well, so definitely don't do that. If you want to show up in scrubs, that's fine as well. Be ready to talk about your experiences. We also do behavioral and situational questions. So a lot of stuff around, challenging patients or situations. Also safety, again, with the mission, how have you showed compassion, things like that. With our benefits, they do vary slightly from region to region, but we do offer benefits on day one, so there's no waiting period, which is absolutely phenomenal. They do include medical, dental, vision, life and disability insurance, a retirement plan. We also have a 403B, and then paid vacation, which starts accruing on your first pay period as well.
We are, you know, a very large organization, and in all of our states, we offer services ranging from hospital acute care to home health, hospice, to the clinic. So there's a lot of opportunities regardless of, you know, whatever you're looking for. So in the clinics right now, we are recruiting for and looking for, you know, MAs, RNs. We're looking for patient service representatives, HISs or health information specialists. We also recruit for social workers and clinical psychologists in the clinics as well that offer mental health services in those primary and specialty care clinics. So it's a wide gamut, so it really depends on what you're looking for, what your interest is, and what type of specialty area you're looking to get exposure in, because we call them different flavors, but every part of the organization kind of has a different tangent, and so it really depends on what kind of services you're looking to provide and how you feel like you can make an impact. So so that's why it's kind of hard to talk about one specific role, because there's just so much that is available at Providence right now. And know what you're interested in. Do you want to work with the geriatric population? Do you want to work with PEDS patients? So, you know, just be informed as applicants, because if you pursue and show an interest in something, you know, that'll allow you to have an upper hand or an edge to those managers where you're showing your passion for a certain patient population. So, interview tips. Again, we also utilize behavioral interviewing and situational-based interviewing. What I would say is, kind of regardless of the company you're applying to and the organization specifically, what managers and what we in recruiting really want to look for is how do you approach customer service in a healthcare organization. Each organization kind of has a different flavor of how they approach that, but you know, I know at Providence we really do provide compassionate care, which is how do you provide, you know, empathy and customer service not only to patients but their families in, you know, hard, you know, in really difficult situations. So tell us about, you know, how you would walk a patient through that process. You know, what have you done in a customer service job before, if not healthcare, that can maybe be a parallel to the kind of work that you may be going or maybe doing in a, you know, in a healthcare position. So we really want to drill down to what gets you motivated, how you've operated in the past, and those behaviors that would lead us to believe that you would operate in a similar fashion. But in regards to tips, yeah, please dress for success. I'd like to just mirror what everyone else has said. You know, just be polished. You know, you don't have to have the most expensive clothes, but just have confidence in yourself. Just carry yourself in a professional way. Just, you know, show up for the job you want to have. So just be ready to go. Don't be late. Please turn your cell phone off. We have heard horror stories of people that have actually had conversations on their cell phone while they've been in an interview. So kind of mind-boggling, but just be ready to showcase your skills and experience, and let your experience speak for itself. Just have confidence in yourself.